Just the latest incident in what has been a very violent week in Chicago. 50 shootings one weekend alone, 10 people dead, including an innocent little girl. Joining us to talk about this morning, police union spokesman Pat Camden. Pat, first, thank you for being here. We just want to
say,
tell us about Del Pearson. Everyone has been praying for him and his recovery. What do we know about it?
He's doing well. He's starting the first step of his recovery. The biggest problem was stopping the bleeding and getting him stabilized, which they did in surgery to the tune of about 6 or 7 hours. They literally had to crack his collarbone to repair the vascular damage that was done. So now the next step will become getting him strong enough so that he can withstand the next surgery to remove the bullet that's still lodged.
Well, we hope for the sake of his wife, his children, himself, and the entire police department, we're hoping
absolutely.
That he is going to be okay. You know, I also want to ask you this about the extreme uptick in violence. I mean, we see violence on our streets here in Chicago, but what we've just seen, I think, is shocking. 10 people killed in one weekend. 50 shootings, a police officer then critically injured a couple days later. What do you make of what we're seeing on our streets?
Well, in this past month, from February 19th through March 19th, we've had 3 police officers shot. Mm. Now, if they're going to shoot at police officers, the level of violence that's increasing it's the mentality of the thugs that are out there, the gang members that are there, that at this point in time just aren't being dealt with, you know, sufficiently. They're roaming the streets. They don't respect anybody, let alone the police. There is no fear of the police. They're out there just taking over the streets and brandishing guns on a very loosey-goosey basis.
And as we saw, the little child, the little girl was shot, was another innocent victim. We've seen
Absolutely.
So many of these, Pat. And I guess the question is, if you're saying they'll shoot at police officers, they'll shoot at anybody, what can you do to fight that?
Well, if we go back to 2002, where we had over 600 homicides and we were called the murder capital of the United States, you know, Terry Hillard was the superintendent. We started to focus on gangs, guns, and drugs. We had 13,500 policemen that the Superintendent McCarthy refers to at this point with that high murder rate. We also had specialized units that were put into place to attack gangs, guns, and drugs. By 2007, the murder rate was down to 414. Right now, we do not have any specialized units that can go directly after gangs. We've taken the additional police officers that have been removed from administrative units, put them in 2 districts. And we're going to control the gang problems because they're only in 2 districts. It's not working. We are tremendously short on manpower. And because of that shortage of manpower, we're not able to have the units out there to attack these roving gangs that are there. And as I mentioned yesterday in a radio interview, we were very successful in putting gang leaders in jail. One of the residuals of that is that these gangs now have little factions that are trying to fight for territory. They're fighting among themselves, and they don't care who gets in the middle of it.
Maybe you can explain something to me, because Jody Weiss, our former superintendent, was not given a new contract. He was under his tenure, though, we saw crime go down, but he didn't have the respect of the rank and file. That was one of the reasons cited. Now we have a new police chief, a new superintendent. How do you think he's doing?
Well, unfortunately, the administration continues to think we don't have capable superintendents within the rank and file of the Chicago Police Department. I respectfully disagree with them. Terry Hillard, Phil Klein did outstanding jobs with it. There were people in the wings that could have replaced them. When you come from within the infrastructure of the Chicago Police Department, you understand what is going on. Unfortunately, Jody Weiss was not a police officer. He was an FBI agent. He has no idea what it is to be a police officer. Superintendent McCarthy, he's coming in from New York, where his experience is, again, respectfully, this isn't New York, this is Chicago. We have gang situations that are, you know, just endemic to Chicago. And again, jumping over real quickly, part of the problem is we have nowhere to put these gang members. They arrested 1,800 maniac Latin disciples. How many of them were out within a 2-3 day period
of time?
That
is the other problem. You're right, to come back out to commit more crimes. Pat, we so many issues to get to, and we hope you'll come back on Good Day Chicago to discuss them with us. We appreciate it.
Be my pleasure. Thank you for having me.